Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, our third video on conditional probability. Starting with something we should already know, pause the video and answer these questions. So hopefully you got the following, and this was a classic case of conditional probability where the probabilities of the colour marbles you get on the second pick is influenced by what you got on the first pick because you did not replace the marble in the bag. Okay, in general, it doesn't have to be about marbles and taking them out of bags. We can be a bit more general with general events A and B. And so I want to go into something like this and show you a general tree diagram we can always draw with conditional probability. Let's assume we've got two events A and B and they are dependent. Let's assume A happens first, just for now. Then we can always draw the following tree diagram. Right, let's assume A happens or not. There's the decision. So either we have A happens like that, or A doesn't happen, which a mathematician writes like that, A dashed, which is the same thing as not A. See the set theory notation to see that. So let's label the probabilities. This here is the probability that A happens, and this here is the probability that A doesn't happen. Now, after A happens, we've said that B happens afterwards. So let's think of the scenario. Let's go along here. A has happened. This here is then the outcome that B happens after it, or B doesn't happen. So what probability should we write here? Well, this is the probability that B happens given A has happened. And this one is the probability that B doesn't happen given A has happened. So it's really important we label it up properly. And finishing this off here, let's go down the scenario where initially A doesn't happen. Afterwards, either B can happen or obviously it doesn't. This probability here is the probability that you get B or B happens given A didn't happen, and this here is the probability that B doesn't happen given A didn't happen, like that. And we can always draw this diagram here, and we can state each of the following. And these are going to be important to us in the future. We're going to use that formula with more complicated scenarios, but just to show you, in principle, we can always draw this diagram. So let's move on and try a question. Pause the video and see if you can have a go at the following question. Right, it says the probability it rains in London on any particular day is 0.1. If it rains, then, so the probability of rain the following day increases to 0.25. So dependent on what happened the day before, whatever happens the day before influences the probability of rain the next day. So this is definitely a conditional probability scenario, or dependent probabilities. Now it says consider the next 2 days. What is the probability it rains both days? It won't rain on either day. It rains on just one of those days. This is a perfect scenario where we can draw a probability tree. So let's think of day one. What are the options that can happen on day one? Well, on the first day, it either rains, which I'll put R like that, or it doesn't rain. Now, on the first day, given we know nothing about other days, the probability in general it rains is 0.1. So we can put the probability it rains is 0.1. Therefore, we know the probability it doesn't rain must be 1 subtract that, which is 0.9. Now, let's think really carefully about what happens subsequent to that on the second day. So let's go down the two possible scenarios. I'll just label this first. Now, if it did rain on the first day, the probability it rains on the second day, we're told in the question, increases to 0.25. So we know the probability it rains, given it's already rained, is 0.25. And therefore, we know that the probability it doesn't rain, given it rained on the first day, is 1 subtract that, 0.75. Okay, now let's assume on the first day it didn't rain. Now, if it didn't rain, you just got to assume the probability it rains on any given day is 0.1. We're not told it whether that changes or not. So the probability it rains, given it didn't rain, is just the usual probability, 0.1. And the probability it doesn't rain, given it didn't rain the day before, must be 1 subtract that, is 0.9. Right, and we've got all the probabilities we need there. So let's actually go on and work out some of these probabilities. It says, consider the next 2 days. What is the probability it rains both days? You're looking for the probability of rain on both days, which is this scenario here. The probability of rain and rain is going to be the probability of rain on the first day, which is 0.1, multiplied by the probability it rains, given it rained on the first day, which is 0.25. And if you work that out, that is going to be equal to 0.025, like that. Now, next, what is the probability it will not rain on either day? That means it didn't rain the first day and it didn't rain the second day. That must be this probability here, not rain and not rain. So what are we going to do? We're going to do 0.9 multiplied by 0.9, which is going to be equal to 0.81, like that. Now, the last question, it says, what is the probability it rains on just one of those days? So that's the two scenarios. Either, okay, let's do this in a different color. Either it rained on the first day and didn't rain on the second day, or it didn't rain on the first day and it did rain on the second day. And these two probabilities multiplying along, 0.1 multiplied by 0.75 is 0.075, and this one, 0.9 multiplied by 0.1 is 0.09. So we can add these two together as follows, and we would get ourselves the probability rain on one day is going to be this one added to this one, which is going to be 0.165, and that's it, we're done. Okay, let's have a go at another question. Pause the video and have a go here. Okay, it says the performance of a cyclist in a race is affected by whether it rains or not on that day. The probability the cyclist crashes is 7/10 when it's raining and is 1/10 when it's dry. So this is a clear scenario of conditional probabilities. Depending on whether it rained or not in the day depends on whether what the probability is of the cyclist crashing. It then says on a given day the probability of rain is 1/3. What is the probability the cyclist crashes on any given day? So let's set up a tree diagram to help us through this one. Now, what do you think is the first branch of the tree diagram? Should we consider it raining, or should we consider whether he crashes? Well, let's consider whether it's raining or not, because that's the thing where his crash is dependent on, it seems. So drawing this out, let's draw a tree diagram saying either rains or doesn't rain. So we can label it like that. Now, we're told in the question, on any given day, the probability it rains is 1/3. So the probability of rain is 1/3, which means the probability of not rain must be 1 subtract this, which is 2/3. Now, this is where we can really put in the information in the question. Let's consider the scenario where it did rain, and then he either crashes his bike, or hopefully he doesn't crash his bike. So let's see if there's any information. It says the probability the cyclist crashes is 7/10 when it's raining. So we know the probability that he crashes, given that it's raining, is 7/10. Which means for sure that the probability he doesn't crash, given it's raining, is 1 subtract that, which is 3/10. And we've dealt with that scenario. Let's go down the other scenario where on the day it doesn't rain. And let's see what we can do here. It either crashes or hopefully doesn't crash. Are we given any information? Well, it says the probability the cyclist crashes is 1/10 when it is dry, i.e. when it doesn't rain. So we know the probability that he crashes, given it didn't rain, is 1/10. So therefore the probability he doesn't crash, given it didn't rain, is 1 subtract that, is 9/10. So there's our probability tree, and we can answer any question from that. It says the overall question we've got to answer is, what is the probability the cyclist crashes on any given day? Well, let's just think of the scenarios. Either he crashes after it rained, or he crashes after it didn't rain. So it's these two scenarios here. So it would be the probability of rain, given he crashes, is going to be these two multiplied 1/3 multiplied by 7/10, which is 7/30. Or this one, the probability it didn't rain and he crashed, which is 2/3 multiplied by 1/10, which is going to be 2 out of 30. And we combine these probabilities, we add this one and add this one, and therefore the probability we can state of a crash is going to be 9 out of 30, which we can simplify to 3/10, and we're done. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks for watching.